You're watching Chicago Cooks. Every summer at the Taste of Chicago, some of the most talented chefs from Chicago's top restaurants gather at the cooking corner to demonstrate their skills. Here is your chance to learn from the pros. They'll share their favorite recipes and kitchen techniques. So enjoy your visit with the people from some of our finest eateries here on Chicago Cooks.
Hi, I'm Lori Perrette with Cakewalk Chicago. We're at 1741 West 99th Street in Chicago, and we're going to be working on cupcake decorating today. I hope to give you some great ideas for making all of your special occasions fantastic with a little bit of work. Hi guys, welcome. We're going to do cupcakes today, and I'm going to try to squeeze a lot of stuff into a little bit of time, so I hope that you enjoy it. I'm not actually going to bake any cupcakes today, but mostly I'm going to focus on the process of making them beautiful for whatever special occasion that you have. We'll be working with a buttercream icing, we'll be working a little bit with rolled fondant, we'll be working a little bit with some ready-to-use decorative elements that are edible, and maybe a couple non-edible, I don't remember. So we can start with just the cupcakes themselves. Any standard cake recipe or cake mix will create beautiful cupcakes. You don't have to stress out about finding the perfect recipe. Part of the trick is just making sure that you're comfortable with it. If you are smart enough and have the time to bake from scratch, I think that's wonderful. And if you are smart enough and have the time to go to the store and get a mix, I think that's wonderful too. So you choose the one that's going to work for you, and then you personalize it by your decorating prowess. So when you are doing cupcakes, I'm going to demonstrate in these mini cupcake tins. Some of them are smaller, 12 cup, and some are 24 cup, depending on the capacity. I have some cake batter here. And I find part of the challenge of doing cupcakes is making sure that you get the right amount in the cup and making sure it's the same every time. So I found that cookie scoops work great for that. So for this, we're going to use a 1 ounce cookie scoop, and I'll just show you how to fill that. If you're doing a standard cupcake, then you can do a 2 to 3 ounce scoop depending on how full you would like it to be. And these serve double duty for ice cream or for cookies and things like that at different times of the year. So as long as you're neat, I got a little handshake here. As long as you're neat, then the cupcakes will come out neatly. There you go, look at that second one. You can make batter and then store some in the refrigerator because you don't always get a chance to bake it off at the same time. So if you go ahead and make your batter and then store the remaining of it in the fridge until your pans are ready, then that's perfectly fine. Some people actually fill the cupcake liners and pop these into the freezer, and then when they need a muffin or a cupcake, they can just pull it out and have something freshly baked every time. So you don't have to worry about planning it really far ahead to get it done. So that would be baking off your cupcakes. Mini cupcakes take about 10 to 15 minutes to bake, and then the standard size maybe up to 20 minutes, and then they even have jumbo cupcakes, which could take 30 minutes or more, depending on what your recipe is. You can take a ready-to-use cupcake, and you can add a little special filling. You can make a peanut butter cupcake and then add some jelly and have a PB&J cupcake, or you can make a chocolate cupcake and add a cream filling and have one that's very similar to one of those commercial brands, but probably it'll taste a little bit better. If I'm going to fill, I actually take a tip that's designed to go way deep into that cupcake, and what's going to happen is going to displace a little bit of the cake. So I take my filling, whether I made it from scratch or whether I purchased it commercially, and then I squeeze it right into the top. And it displaces a little bit of the cake, and so when it begins to kind of rise to the top, then I know that it's full. And then I just take it and scrape it across to make it flat. And you can fill all of your cupcakes with a special filling if you want to, and then if you're doing chocolate, do a cream filling and top it with the chocolate ganache or anything that you want to do. So that would be filling the cupcakes and baking them off. And now let's start with the good part. You guys are all familiar with buttercream icing, right? It's the icing that scares you a little bit because you don't know quite what to do with it. Part of the challenge is the grocery store icing is not really designed to pipe out a design that's going to hold its shape. It's smooth and it's creamy, melt in your mouth, and so it tastes great, but when you try to squeeze it out, it doesn't work very well. So what you're going to need to do is to find a great recipe for a standard bakery buttercream icing, which generally has powdered sugar and shortening, or powdered sugar and butter, a little bit of liquid and some flavor, or to find a commercial buttercream that is designed for actually piping out designs. So I've got some parchment paper bags here. You can also use disposable pastry bags, and you can use reusable pastry bags. I am a fan of the pastry bag. I know I watch some people on TV and they say, oh, I just take a Ziploc bag and I put something in and I snip it off. Well, when I do that, I got a mess and nothing comes out looking right. So there's a reason that 100 or so odd years ago, somebody said, hey, let's use a bag and a cone to squeeze out decorations for a cake. So I do recommend these. You can use parchment paper, and generally it comes in a triangle, and you'll just fold it into a cone. Now, it's easier said than done for some people, so don't be stressed out if you try it the first time and it doesn't quite work the way that you want it to. Try it again and keep trying. It actually does work very well. It's sanitary as long as you keep them clean. It's the ultimate in disposable. You use it and you throw it in the trash and you're all done. You don't have to clean anything out. My husband wishes I would use more of them, but I don't. All right, so into these parchment paper bags, I put in a variety of tips. I'm going to be working with leaf tip today, large open star tip, and some smaller star tips. So I'm just going to show you just some general decorations and things that you can practice at home and then see how you can apply them to your cupcakes. So you can take a large open star tip and you can squeeze out decorations that have a little bit of body and that are nice and big. Probably one of the more traditional shapes that we'll see is one that goes around like this, which everybody loves, right? You can take smaller tips and do similar things. Depending on how hard you squeeze, that'll determine how big your design is. And the tips are numbered, so the smaller the number, the smaller the opening. Typically, 1 through 12 are round, and then 13 through 20 through 32 are stars, and then as you begin to work with them, you'll learn a little bit more about what tip does what function. We're also going to be working with the leaf tip. So what I'm doing when I pipe is I'm squeezing and giving it nice, firm pressure, and then just as I get ready to finish, I kind of let go and taper it off. It's all about pressure. You'll create a rhythm when you'll pipe. You'll say squeeze, stop, lift, and then that'll keep it from going too high or getting too wide and things like that. And as you, the more you practice, the better it'll get. So some of the designs that we'll be working with today are like this. And so getting good at this is really all about practice. Nobody who does cake decorating or anything got it on the very first try. Well, maybe a couple people, but most people don't get it on the first try. So don't be discouraged. If you're not having fun, you're not doing it right. This is something that really is supposed to be enjoyable. And if you're stressing about it, whoever you're giving it for is not going to enjoy quite as much. All right, so stop talking, Lori, and move on to some cupcakes. I don't even know where to start. So I'm going to try to go through the seasons a little bit. So we've got little green. I'm going to start with Christmas in July. I'm trying to see if I can cool myself down a little bit by channeling a little bit of December in Chicago. So I'm going to start. I have some green icing. When I am making colors for icing, I use gel colors. Doesn't matter what brand, they're all good. The difference between a gel color and a grocery store color is that grocery store colors are liquid, and it takes an awful lot of color to make deep, dark, rich colors, which can change the consistency of your icing. So if you need to make it really dark, then you can thin it down, and your decoration may not pipe out the way that you want it to. Also, grocery store colors don't usually give you the range of colors that you may be interested in having. So if I want a teal blue to make a Tiffany box cake, for instance, that's going to be really hard to do with the grocery store color. Some use ice smoothly, and smoothness doesn't have to be perfect. I know a lot of people try to make them perfect, but if you look in the magazines and on TV at those $100,000 cakes, they're not perfect unless they airbrush them out. So don't stress yourself out trying to make them look perfect. All right, so I iced this smooth, and remember that leaf that we used? Get my little cheat sheet here. I'm going to turn it and make sure I have the right orientation for my leaf tip. I'm going to pull out, squeeze really hard. It's working already.